How do you file your own LLC? Should you use Incfile, Zen Business, LegalZoom, or some other service? Or should you file your LLC by yourself? DIY, file the LLC, is the way to go. It's less expensive and you take that control into your own hands. In this video, I'm going to give you the three simple steps to file your LLC in your home state using your state government's website. And I'm going to give you tips and tricks that I've learned along the way so you can avoid the mistakes that I made the first time around. I've been around the block when it comes to starting a business and being a solo entrepreneur, single member LLC, all of the things that you may be interested in. In fact, the reason I'm making this video, which is a follow-up to my 2018 video called How to File an LLC, Best Tips No One Told Me, is that that video has become my most popular YouTube video of all time. It has over 7,500 views at the moment, and this video does not have good sound quality. I didn't really know what I was doing. I shot it outside, which was a big mistake, obviously, but the fact is, this year, 2020, with the corona economy, searches for Incfile review, how to file an LLC, and other similar search terms have gone through the roof and sent me thousands of views on that video, which I'm slightly embarrassed about the quality on, so that is why I'm filming my update here. I also have more information to share with you, things I've learned in the past couple years as I continue owning and operating my business. My name is Emily Binder. I am the founder of Beetle Moment Marketing and of a startup called Wealth Voice. I focus on voice marketing, I consult with companies, I provide marketing strategy and advice, but I'm also very much into personal finance. And I make videos about topics on those kinds of questions as well. I've gotten so many questions from people on YouTube about how do I file an LLC? Should I use Incfile? I've even had conversations on Twitter about this. So I really wanted to come back here and give you the lowdown. If you're interested in owning your own business, being an entrepreneur, taking matters into your own hands, and avoiding taxes, give this video a thumbs up now. If you have any questions, leave them below in the comments, and I respond to everybody. You can see from my 2018 video that one of the reasons it's gotten so popular is that I'm actually happy to help you. I wish there had been somebody I could ask these questions to when I was getting started. All right, so what are the three steps in filing your LLC? The first thing is figuring out what you're going to name the business. Now, what you need to do is a name search. You can do this on your Secretary of State's website in your home state. This is something I covered in the past video. I will say it again. Don't mess around with filing in Delaware, Vermont, Wyoming, Nevada. Yes, these states are a little more tax friendly for larger businesses. If you're just doing a single member LLC, save yourself the hassle and the headache of being what's called a foreign entity, i.e. operating in another state from where you are registered. Just do it in your home state. I've done it in Georgia, I've done it in Texas. It was always easier and better to just do it in my home state. You'll notice that a lot of major corporations are Delaware companies for good reason. Delaware is very business friendly for large corps. You're probably not a large corporation. Don't worry about it. So what you're going to do is go to Google and look up Secretary of State and then your state. You're looking for a .gov website. Ignore the paid search results and the ads from Incfile and LegalZoom and Zen Business and all of these services that are actually masquerading like they're the proper website where you go to file. They're not. They're paid services and you don't really need them. Nothing against them, but this is about DIY. And you will do what's called a taxable entity search or similar name. What you're looking for is there another business in my state that has the name that I want? You obviously want to avoid that because you need to have a unique LLC. Another tip about choosing your name. Don't stress too much on this because you can have an LLC that is not your DBA, doing business as. In fact, in some ways, it's good to have kind of a secret LLC name, something that isn't recognizable because it actually protects you for certain legal reasons. Don't worry too much about it. Just think about what is the name of your business and you can have a slightly different DBA if you need to. You're going to type in what you think you're going to be calling your LLC. Let's say that it's called Miguel's Flower Company LLC. You're going to be a florist. And you type it in and it's available. Great. If it's not available, you need to change the name. Take out a word, add a word, say it a different way. Don't stress too much about the particular name of the LLC because what you can do is have a DBA, doing business as. You might have your true LLC as one name, but your storefront, your signage, your website, your business card, all that could be your DBA. It's up to you. This is really just for legal purposes. And P.S., this is another tip, and this is kind of a personal preference, but when you actually write the LLC that needs to be included in the name, don't put in extra periods and make it weird and confusing. Go with the simplest and shortest style, which is three capital letters, LLC. I wouldn't mess with periods. I wouldn't mess with commas. For example, my business is called Beetle Moment Marketing LLC. There are no periods or commas or confusing punctuation, and then it makes everything easier. People are more likely to default to that in contracts, and you want your LLC to be written properly in a contract, otherwise the contract is void. So just use a simple LLC in all caps. Don't use commas, don't use periods. Okay, so we've covered tip number one about the name search. Assuming your name is available, great. The next step is to fill out your forms, like your articles of organization, your articles of formation. These will be readily available on most of the Secretary of State websites. It's where you're basically filling it in, or they'll have a template rubric that guides you on what to do. It's not a big deal and it's not scary. You can do it, don't need Incfile to do it for you. So with those articles of organization, you're going to need basic information like the name of the business, use your LLC, the address of the business. You can use your home address. If you're a solopreneur, a freelancer, if you have an online business, if you're a YouTuber, you should have an LLC, by the way, if you're any of these things, then use your home address. But you also need something called a registered agent. Don't be intimidated by this. It's not a big deal. If you don't have a physical storefront, then get a registered agent. You can pay a service $50 or $75 a year. There are services that purely specialize in this. Just Google registered agent and then put in your city name or your state name. I have one in Texas. They're out somewhere in a town I've never heard of, and they can receive mail for me if I ever get sued. Knock on wood, that doesn't happen. But the point of a registered agent is it's a physical storefront, an address that's open during business hours and can receive a court summons or any kind of important mail. You're really not going to use it for much else. However, I will give you this tip. When you're doing email marketing, if you have a home address and you have a registered agent, use that registered agent address for your canned spam email signature required physical address. Don't put out your home address on that, because you're gonna have, especially if you're a woman, crazy stalkers can find where you live. It's just, you don't wanna mess with that. The beauty of the registered agent, it's like a veil of security, almost like a PO box. So get a registered agent if you don't have a storefront. After you have filed these documents, the articles of formation, organization, on your state's government website, there might be a little time for processing, and you will have to put in a credit card most likely to do this all online. If anyone tells you you need to file paper forms, don't. Leave it in the comments below if you live in a state where that's required, because I haven't heard of that. But nowadays, it should all be done online. Ignore advice when someone says, oh, fax it in. You should be able to do it online. But I could be wrong, so let me know in the comments if there's a state where you can't. Anyway, so once you have filed these documents online, wait however long the period is. It might be a day, it might be a week. You'll get an email from your state government saying, congratulations, your LLC has been approved and filed. Follow any instructions that come after that, and you are G to G. You have a business. Congratulations. The third step is to create your operating agreement. You may have to do this before you actually file, or you could possibly do it afterward, depending on your state. All this operating agreement needs to be is essentially an agreement between you and you as a member of your LLC, especially for solo member LLC. This video is not about multiple members or anything complicated, partnerships, some single member LLC tips, really. So if you don't know what to do for this and your state isn't giving you a template or a rubric, just Google LLC operating agreement, single member, and just grab a template and copy and paste it, or, you know, just fill it out. All it has to say basically is how are you going to run the business, who's getting paid what. If you're not giving yourself a salary, then don't worry about that. You don't have to take a salary. Most LLCs are not set up for that. You might need an S corp if you want to do a salary. Don't file an S corp at first. If you want to keep things simple, start with an LLC. You could always go up to an S corp from that LLC. However, you cannot go from an S corp down to an LLC. You would have to start a whole new business and the process begins again. But just start with an LLC to get your feet wet. To wrap up, we went over the three steps to file your LLC. The first is to do your name search. The second is to file all of the paperwork online, including your articles of formation. And the third is your operating agreement, which is a simple document, contract between you and yourself, essentially. You can do this all on your state's Secretary of State government website. Remember that the name is not make or break super important, but my tip about that would be leave out the periods and the commas and all the doodads and punctuation. Just keep it super simple. It's going to look much nicer on your Chase Inc. business credit card so you can max out your UR points. That's a whole other video, but I'll link to that below. One of the best things about having an LLC is that you can write off business expenses and participate in business credit card rewards. I have other videos about that. If you're into that, leave a comment below and I can talk more about that. Otherwise, let me know if you have any other questions about this. I'm happy to answer them. Leave them in the comments below. If this video was helpful, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I am trying to grow this YouTube channel so that I can keep putting out more content like this to help other business owners like you. So if you subscribe, that helps me to do that. My name is Emily Bender. I'm the founder of Beetle Moment Marketing and Wealth Voice. Thanks for watching and good luck with your business. You might be, let's not use Karen. I was going to use Karen as an example, but Karina's Flower Company. That might be your LLC.